30 years ago today, NASA entered a new phase of space travel. The first crew of Space Shuttle Columbia made their way to the launch pad to board their ship and make space flight history. Well, another historic decision comes today as NASA sends four shuttles to museums across the country, but it was disappointing news for Dayton. News 5's Stephanie Stone is here with their story. Steph?
Dayton area congressmen are calling it a slap in the face, and as you said, disappointing. Tonight, they want to know why they didn't make the cut.
I think thematically, it belongs in the birthplace of aviation. A flying space shuttle retired belongs in the birthplace of aviation.
Some 1,500 people were invited to view NASA's announcement from the Air Force Museum in Dayton. Those same people shared their feelings after NASA Administrator Charles Bolden announced where the shuttles would be going: New York, Florida, California, and D.C. Dayton wasn't on the list.
There were many, many worthy institutions that requested an orbiter, and only four to go around.
Well, obviously, that would be incredibly disappointing, not just that that it would not be going here, but where it would be going, because those are locations that, you know, they've not contributed to space flight, they've not contributed to aerospace and tell the history that we can here.
It was a mission that was nearly 3 years in the works, and a mission that proved a collaboration in the Dayton community, one that holds its head high, even though upset with the outcome.
This competition that they put together and then deciding New York, L.A., D.C., and Florida, perhaps, really shows that they gave no thought to how the story of the space shuttle would be told.
And in the end,
for all of them, take good care of our vehicles. They've served the nation well, and we at NASA have a deep and abiding relationship and love affair with them.
A heartfelt goodbye to an era.
Now, there's still two more shuttle flights before the program officially ends this summer. Jack?